Welcome to CS++, where we try to make computer science as accessible and available and approachable as possible. This is a video in the CS101 series. You can watch any videos in the CS101 series in any order that you would like to. In this video, I'm going to discuss the differences between functions and procedures. Now, I'm not going to show any actual program code here today, but we're going to cover the notion of functions, procedures, and pure. So from the mathematical perspective, a function returns a value and always returns the same value given the same input. This is what math tells us. So if you have taken algebra, then you may have seen something like f of x equals x squared. That is a function from the mathematical perspective. In programming, or in computer science, we might see something like this. We could declare a function called square. It takes an input called x, and it returns x times x. This is a function. Now, the reason I'm making a separation here between what math says and what computer science says about functions is, well, the tricky fact that we can have functions in computer science that don't always return the same value. Where we might do something like this, get a random number and return it. This is not a mathematical function. So these concepts between mathematical functions and computer science functions are often used interchangeably in computer science. So that's going to bring us to the notion of procedure. This is often used interchangeably with functions in computer science. As we already saw, you can create a function or a procedure in most programming languages that takes no input and returns a different value every time it is executed. That is not a mathematical function. We can also do things like this in computer science, where we take no inputs, return no outputs, and simply do something in the I/O world that happens in some other device somewhere else. Now, the point of these things I'm going to say two primary reasons. We're going to make code more human readable. If I said something like square of x plus the cube of x, you know what I mean. Whereas if I were to have written this, x times x plus x times x times x, that's harder to read. And the other reason is to avoid repeating ourselves. This is code reuse and dry, a principle common in software engineering. That stands for don't repeat yourself. Okay, so that covers functions and procedures. Now, that brings us to the topic of pure. In computer science, to distinguish the generic functions and procedures from the math things, we might say that a function is pure. Now, the key problem here is that a strict definition of function from mathematics means that you have one input to one output. So this is supposed to actually read 1, 2, 1, one input to one output. Except in the computer science world, we might say it is a pure function if it meets the math definition of being a function. But we allow more than one input. Okay, so that at a very high level with what we're going to call this here. So I'm going to introduce another term right now. This is going to be called pseudocode. Pseudocode is code that is not from any specific language. This is just a way of expressing a concept without tying yourself to a specific programming language. And there are a lot of programming languages. So now time for the homework. Let's think about a problem you are currently working on. And then break it down into a set of steps that could theoretically be functions. This could be as simple as get up, put on shoes, grab leash, walk dog. Thanks for watching this episode of CS++. I hope to see you in the next one.